गुड मॉर्निंग मैडम, नमस्ते मैडम, योर वॉइस इज अनम्यूट, वॉल्यूम।
गुड मॉर्निंग पाटिल सर।
मॉर्निंग मैडम, विद इन वन मिनट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट दिस सेशन। Good morning, participants. Welcome for this beautiful session, Physical Education and Community Coaching Program. I welcome you all on behalf of Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports, Ministry of Women and Child Development, Fit India, Khelo India, SAI LNCP, on behalf of our principal, sir. Today we have a special a guest and a special speaker, really inspiring, a motivating speaker, especially health-oriented personality, is there with us, Madam Rohini Raman. About her, Madam has qualified MSc and a registered dietitian, International Olympic Committee, qualified sports nutritionist, special interest in athletes and women's nutrition. Madam has a greater experience of 20 years in this nutrition, sports nutrition field, experience in the clinical and sports nutrition. A major area of interest has always been a fitness, specifically focusing on women's. Currently working for the Sports Authority of India, Thiruvananthapuram, as a sports nutritionist. Worked earlier in diverse field of nutrition in both the private, like Tata High Performance Center, and the government sectors, Sports Authority of India. Madam has given a greater priority area of working as always been a woman, as they form a larger part of segment that has been unfairly targeted for their physical, among other things. Madam involves in nutritional assessment and counseling athletes from grassroots school, university, national and international competitions. Recent time, Madam has been devoted to preparing the athletes team for the 2020 Olympics. She has a greater achievements in this field also. Today she is a presenter and a chief guest for us. It's a great privilege for us to see her in this session as an a speaker also. We are lucky today Madam is there with us. And on behalf of Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports, Ministry of Women and Child Development, Fit India, Khelo India, SAI LNCP, and on behalf of our respected principal, sir, I welcome you, Madam, for this beautiful session.
Thank you, Patil sir, Madam, very much.
Today we are lucky that you are here. Even our participants are lucky that today we have got a data inspiring a nutritionist. Even our participants are eagerly waiting for your presentation. Platform is yours, Madam.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
You can take over this, Madam.
Thank you, Mayas, Ministry of Youth and Sports Welfare. Thank you, LNCP, SAI, and COE Trivandrum. And thank you, Patil sir, for considering me for this particular workshop. when this topic was told to me, I was very happy to take it up for a certain reason, because it concerns, one, it concerns fitness, and two, it concerns women who are in this field. And I feel privileged to be a part of this program, to share my knowledge and expertise, what I have gained over the years. Today, what we are talking about is a balanced nutrition and lifestyle for school children. I have been a woman and I have been a mother as well. And I have two kids, adolescent kids, who have typical adolescent behaviors and who rebel against healthy food and who need to be made aware of what actually food is, what actually fitness is. I'm sure all women and especially mothers or physical education teachers and all women who take care of children have to go through this, trying to explain to children what they need to eat for a healthy and balanced life, and something that actually affects their health and future in the long term. So normally we discuss fitness in two sessions, namely the fitness for short term and fitness for long term. I do not believe in fitness for short term. I believe in fitness for long term. So whatever habits as a woman or as a child that we inculcate stays with us the whole life. And fitness need not be expensive. Fitness need not be time consuming. Fitness just needs to be followed. It's a disciplined life within what infrastructure all of us have that or that we can afford. So let's start with the first slide. Now, what are healthy eating habits? What the research that always I have keep seeing in the media, or what we have seen practically from a lot of school children that we interact, the athletes that we interact with, almost 56% of primary and 80% of secondary children, they do not eat vegetables. That I have been experiencing with my own kids, with the kids that I interact with in the academy as well. And it takes extreme effort from us to make them understand that vegetables as a part of a normal routine diet is extremely important. Children find vegetables very, very boring to eat. Sometimes, they don't find it tasty. So, there are different ways of inculcating this particular group of food into their diet. That is one aspect. The second aspect is another research that shows is that we watch a lot of TV. TV is associated with a lot of meal time that is being spent while watching TV. And children and teenagers drinking a lot of soft drinks and not eating fruit and vegetables. So why are fruit and vegetables important as a part of routine diet? Because that is the only group of food that gives us adequate amount of vitamins, adequate amount of minerals, as well as fiber. These three are the major nutrition that comes from fruits and vegetables. I hardly find, leave children alone, we hardly find even adults eating enough quantity of fruits and vegetables. What the World Health Organization or the normal healthy eating practices say is that we need to have at least 2 to 3 servings in a day of fruit and vegetables. We hardly eat one. Okay. And that too, when we remember, sometimes we don't even remember unless we make extreme effort of remembering that we need to consume fruit. We do it out of compulsion. Not many people have it out of interest. So 2 to 3 servings of vegetables and fruits in all the three meals, namely the breakfast, lunch, dinner, is very, very important. And if you can't have it within these meals, you can plan it during either as a snack or either as a mid-morning meal, after your breakfast at around 11 o'clock. So whenever you're feeling hungry, pick up a fruit or a salad, and please have it as an extra amount during your daily food intake. Now, how do I take charge? What do I understand by a balanced diet? Everybody talks about a balanced diet, but what is a balanced diet? It is very, very simple to understand. People complicate a balanced diet. Balanced diet is nothing but having, in the Indian context, a cereal, a protein, a milk product, say a vegetable and a fruit serving, along with water. That is the most simple form of understanding a balanced diet. In the Indian context, what are cereals? It could be just rice, roti, or it could be any form, like it could be idli, it could be dosa. They all come under major contribution to cereals. Then you also have pulses. Pulses are nothing but dal or lentils, as we call it, or pulses, as in chole, rajma, soya bean. All these come under pulses. Now, what do pulses give? They are extremely high in protein, and they help us, they help the muscle to be very strong. Cereals and pulses as a group give us a lot of energy. They literally fuel our whole day. They are the petrol for your whole day's working. So, for example, if you're feeling very low, tired, and you're in your whole day, you feel that you feel fatigue at the end of the day, maybe you could reconsider how much of cereal and pulses that you're adding to your daily diet. Now, people have this sudden fad nowadays about millets. Okay. So millets are also come under cereals. And we also recommend that you have millets, not on a daily basis, but whenever possible, kindly include millet in your daily diet. Children do not like millets. A lot of children do not like millets. So it is important that you make it in a very interesting form. For example, in Andhra, they eat a lot of ragi. Nowadays, in Maharashtra, you get a nachni. All these come under millets, and bajra roti, jawar roti, all these come under millets. So please try to include these foods along with rice and the normal roti that we eat every day. Or you could, instead of making a plain roti, you could make a wheat plus millet flour roti. That is also a good idea to introduce millet nutrition in both women and children. Why we say millet nutrition? Because they are extremely low in GI. So when that is the glycemic index, as we call it. So when the sugars rise up very fast, you tend to feel hungry very fast. So millets and wheat, etc., they make the sugar rise in the body very slowly and decrease also very slowly. So you don't feel hungry for a very long time compared to what plain rice that you eat. The third most important aspect, as I already discussed, is vegetables and fruits. Why they are important? Because it's a major group of food that gives you a lot of vitamins, minerals. If you see a lot of colored vegetables like tomatoes, beetroots, they give a lot of antioxidants to your body, especially in the COVID time when the immunity needs to be very, very high to combat all kinds of diseases and disorders. Vitamins and minerals are extremely important, like lime. Lime contains a lot of vitamin C. Vitamin D that most of us are deficient in. Even when I see athletes or children roaming around in the sun or playing in the sun, still they are deficient. So include a lot of vitamin D foods in your diet. For example, milk. Milk is a very great source of vitamin D. Also, if you have egg yolks, a lot of people throw away the yolks and they eat only the egg whites. Egg yolks are a very, very important part of vitamin D intake. Apart from that, you have other minerals like sodium, magnesium, potassium. All these are extremely important for daily function of our body. Although they are required in extremely small amounts, it is important that you take them on a regular basis. Sodium also, that is salt, jo hum daily namak khate hain, wo namak bhi hume thoda sa ekdam band nahi karna chahiye, chote amount mein, like small amount mein humko daily लेना चाहिए, क्योंकि नमक हमारे बॉडी को, वो जो इलेक्ट्रोलाइट्स है हमारे बॉडी में, या पानी की मात्रा को ठीक रखता है। तो सोडियम एकदम बंद मत पीजिए, या डोंट कम्प्लीटली स्टॉप सोडियम, और डोंट कम्प्लीटली टेक लॉट ऑफ सोडियम। टेक अ बैलेंस्ड मॉडरेट अमाउंट, मे बी 2 to 3 grams और मैक्सिमम 5 grams इन अ डे, डू नॉट गो बियॉन्ड दैट। हमारे फूड से काफी आ जाता है, ऑलमोस्ट 2 grams to 3 grams कम्स फ्रॉम आवर फूड। रिमेनिंग यू कैन ऐड अ लिटिल अमाउंट ऑफ सॉल्ट फ्रॉम योर डेली, जो आप नमक खाने में ऐड करते हैं। अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट यू हैव मिल्क प्रोडक्ट्स। नाउ व्हाट आर मिल्क प्रोडक्ट्स? नथिंग बट मिल्क, पनीर, चीज, कर्ड, बटर, एवरीथिंग कम्स फ्रॉम डेयरी और द एनिमल मिल्क। दीज आर द मेन सोर्स ऑफ बोथ प्रोटीन and calcium. Protein and calcium both are required in very, very high amounts in our body. Protein is required for muscle, and milk protein is extremely good, one of the best protein for muscle recovery, both for extremely good for athletes as well as growing children. And for women, especially past their 35, 40 years, when the bones or the hormones start reducing in your body, calcium also starts depleting, because calcium absorption is affected. So calcium is extremely important. And how do you add it? You add it through milk. So doodh lene se aapko doodh ya any dairy products, paneer ho ya cheese ho, dahi le lo. Dahi is extremely good. Why? Because dahi mein jo bacteria hota hai, ya probiotics, jo aajkal term use karte hai, scientific log प्रोबायोटिक्स के नाम से यूज करते हैं, दही हमारे शरीर के लिए, हमारे गट जो बोलते हैं या इंटेस्टाइन्स के लिए बहुत अच्छा है। जितना आप दही खाओगे उतना आपका गट ठीक रहेगा या इंटेस्टाइन ठीक रहेगा। सो आपके जो बावल मूवमेंट्स हैं उसको वो ठीक करता है। और फाइबर जो है, फाइबर आपके ऑफकोर्स प्लांट्स और वेजिटेबल्स या फ्रूट्स या वेजिटेबल्स से मिलते हैं। और एक जो चीज बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट यहाँ पर मैं बोलना चाहूंगी, विच आई वॉन्ट टू एड, इज ऑयल। ऑयल कंटेंट, काफी लोग आजकल ऑयल नहीं लेते हैं, दे टेंड टू ईट ऑयल लेस फूड्स। आई हैव सीन लॉट ऑफ पीपल, काफी लोगों को देखी हूँ जिनके स्किन ड्राई हो जाता है विदाउट ऑयल। दे हैव लॉट ऑफ कॉम्प्लिकेशंस इन टर्म्स ऑफ स्किन प्रॉब्लम्स और यू नो कनेक्टिव इश्यू, कनेक्टिव टिश्यू प्रॉब्लम। ऑयल ज्यादा मात्रा में नहीं खाना चाहिए, डीप फ्राइड फूड्स अवॉइड करना चाहिए, बट दैट लिटिल अमाउंट ऑफ ऑयल, मे बी 10 to 20 ml पूरा दिन में, मतलब 3 से 4 स्पून तक, इट इज पर्टिकुलरली रेकमेंडेड टू कीप आवर बॉडी लुब्रिकेटेड। जैसे लुब्रिकेशन, जैसे हम कोई भी इंस्ट्रूमेंट काम करने के लिए लुब्रिकेटिंग ऑयल यूज करते हैं, उसी तरह हमारे बॉडी के लिए भी वो ऑयल की मात्रा बहुत बहुत जरूरत है। जैसे हमारे बॉडी में कोलेस्ट्रॉल फॉर्म होता है, अभी हम बात कर रहे थे कोलेस्ट्रॉल की, तो मुझे याद आया कि यहाँ बोलूं कि कोलेस्ट्रॉल भी हमारे बॉडी के लिए अच्छा है। दैट मिनिमम अमाउंट ऑफ कोलेस्ट्रॉल दैट इज रिक्वायर्ड, 200 milligrams और व्हाटएवर इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द रनिंग ऑफ आवर बॉडी इन टर्म्स ऑफ सेल फॉर्मेशन के लिए या हार्मोन्स फॉर्मेशन के लिए, फैट एंड कोलेस्ट्रॉल इज रिक्वायर्ड। सो डरिए मत ऑयल या फैट से, प्लीज हैव इट इन मॉडरेट अमाउंट्स, मतलब बैलेंस्ड अमाउंट्स में खाना बहुत जरूरी है। अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट यू हैव से जंक फूड, जैसे चिप्स हैं, सॉसेस हैं, या केक्स हैं, मफिन्स हैं, शुगर्ड चॉकलेट्स हैं जो एक्चुअल कोको से नहीं बनता है। ये सब फूड्स आप जितना मिनिमम रखें उतना अच्छा है। पूरा हेल्दी फूड खाकर, बैलेंस्ड डाइट खाकर अगर ये सब भी खाओगे तो इट इज नॉट राइट। खाइए, इन द एंड इट इज लाइफ, यू हैव टू एंजॉय इट। आई डोंट बिलीव इन हैविंग अ वेरी स्ट्रिक्ट डाइट, बट हैव अ मॉडरेशन इन टर्म्स ऑफ जंक डाइट। कभी एक बार, एक दिन वीकली, कीप अ टाइम व्हेन यू आर गोइंग टू एंजॉय योर मील। आई वुडंट कॉल देम जंक फूड्स, बट समथिंग दैट यू लाइक वंस इन अ व्हाइल, please have that, not a problem, but don't make it a habit of having it every day. Most sugar foods or cool drinks have a habit forming tendency. For example, if you're drinking Coke, the body tends to remember the taste and make you remind the next day, wohi time ko aapko sugar ki craving aayegi or Coke ki craving aayegi. So that needs to be avoided. as far as possible, have it in moderation. Once in a week is fine. Now, what is a calorie equation? General balanced diet is fine, but how do I know how many calories I take? मैं कितना calorie खा रही हूँ? वो मुझे कैसे पता चले? Okay. Now, अगर हमें वेट मेंटेन करना है तो जितना हम कैलोरी अंदर लेते हैं उतना हमारी कैलोरी बाहर जानी चाहिए, तभी हम वेट मेंटेन कर सकते हैं. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ आई एम 50 kgs, इफ आई एम टेकिंग 2000 calories इनसाइड एंड आई एक्सपेंड, और या मैं 2000 calories का एक्सरसाइज करती हूँ, चलती हूँ, फिरती हूँ, जो भी करती हूँ, 2000 calories मेरे एक्सपेंड हो जाते हैं या बाहर जाते हैं, तो मैं 50 kgs में मेंटेन कर पाऊंगी. बट अगर मेरा मेंटेनेंस कैलोरीज है से 2000 और मैं खाती हूँ 1500, तो आई विल लूज वेट. बट इफ आई टेक 2500 calories एवरी डे, देन वो जो 500 calories का इंक्रीज आता है हमारे डेली डाइट में, उसके वजह से मेरा वेट ऊपर जाए. सो कैलोरी इन शुड बी इक्वल टू कैलोरी आउट. Any excess calories that the body stores in any form is converted to fat. Now, calorie expenditure three चीजों से maintain होता है. एक तो basal metabolic rate. Basal metabolic rate क्या होती है? That is जो हम daily करते हैं, मेरे body को maintain करने के लिए मेरे को इतनी energy चाहिए. For example, I require 1800 calories as my basal metabolic rate. मुझे सोने के लिए, चलने के लिए, उठ के एक ग्लास पानी लेने के लिए, ये सब के लिए मुझे उतना basal metabolic rate जितना calories चाहिए, जिसमें मैं survive कर पाऊंगी. That's all. इससे नीचे मैं survive नहीं कर पाऊंगी, मेरे systems बंद हो जाएंगे. तो उसे हम basal metabolic rate करते हैं. Base रेट जो बोलते हैं वो अप्रोक्सीमेटली 50-60% या कभी कभी 70% ऑफ बॉडी का जो कैलोरीज है उसमें से निकल जाते हैं. रिमेनिंग 30-40% जो आता है वो फिजिकल एक्टिविटी से आता है. जैसे अगर एथलीट हो तो उसका कैलोरीज बहुत हाई होगा. अगर हम लोग सेडेंटरी लाइफ है, जैसे टीचर्स हैं, तो टीचर्स के लिए कुछ कम होगा, या जो एडमिन लोग काम करते हैं उनके लिए अलग सा होगा. सो डिपेंडिंग ऑन द फिजिकल एक्टिविटी थोड़े कैलोरीज आपको लेने पड़ेंगे. डाइटरी थर्मोजेनेसिस जो तीसरा है, ये है जैसे हम लोग खाते हैं. आपने सुना होगा काफी व्हाट्सएप में मैसेजेस आते रहते हैं, फेसबुक में भी काफी लोग शेयर करते रहते हैं. आपने सुना होगा कि आप कुकुम्बर या ककड़ी खा लो कभी, तो ककड़ी के कैलोरीज कम होंगे बट उसको डाइजेस्ट करने के लिए ज्यादा कैलोरीज एक्सपेंड होते हैं. सो दे आर कॉल्ड एज थर्मोजेनिक फूड्स. तो जितना बॉडी हमारे खाने को डाइजेस्ट करता है, करने के लिए यूज करता है, उसे हम बोलते हैं डाइटरी थर्मोजेनेसिस. तो जो आप खाते हैं, फॉर एग्जाम्पल आप एक रोटी भी खा रहे हैं, इफ यू आर ईटिंग वन रोटी, यू विल रिक्वायर एनर्जी. बॉडी इज यूजिंग एनर्जी टू डाइजेस्ट दैट वन रोटी ऑल्सो. So that is called dietary thermogenesis. So that is approximately 10-15% of your total calorie intake. So ये basal metabolic rate, physical activity और dietary thermogenesis, ये सब मिलके आपका वो 100% का calorie intake होता है, जो आपको पता होना चाहिए when you are actually want to take a stand or take a call on how much food you should be eating in a given particular. This will, इसमें से आप balanced nutrition आप design करके खा सकते हो. Not a very difficult task, you can do it on your own as well. You really don't require an expertise on this. अगर आपको थोड़ा सा knowledge food पर आ गया कि what is a carbohydrate, what is a protein, what is a fat, you can divide it among yourselves and follow it. हमारी calories mainly तीन चीज से आते हैं, वो है carbohydrates, proteins and fats. कैलोरीज एज सच, ये तीनों को हम क्या बोलते हैं? हम बोलते हैं मैक्रोन्यूट्रिएंट्स. दीस थ्री आर कॉल्ड एज मैक्रोन्यूट्रिएंट्स, कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स, प्रोटीन्स एंड फैट्स. बाकी के जो है विटामिन्स, मिनरल्स, एवरीथिंग, दे कम अंडर माइक्रोन्यूट्रिशन. अभी मैक्रोन्यूट्रिएंट्स आपने सीख लिया, माइक्रोन्यूट्रिएंट्स सीख लिया, देयर इज वन मोर एक्सट्रीमली इंपॉर्टेंट. आई वुडंट नेम इट एज न्यूट्रिएंट, बट अ सब्सटेंस ऑलमोस्ट एक्ट्स लाइक अ न्यूट्रिएंट, एंड दैट इज वाटर. Water is extremely important for us because it hydrates our body and keeps us healthy. Without water, none of these carbohydrate, protein, fats, or any micronutrition will work for you unless your water intake is enough. How much water do I take? Minimum at least 3 to 4 liters of water in a given day. You should make sure that at least you have 2 to 3 liters, if not 4 to 5 liters, at least 2 to 3 liters pure din mein, for the whole day. And water does not mean only clean, pure water. It also includes any fluids that contain water. It could include milk, it could include fruit juices, it could include milkshakes. Anything that contains water comes under the fluid intake. But preferably, take in a lot of water. Now, how do I calculate how many calories? Everybody talks about calories. Mujhe itna calorie chahiye, mujhe utna calorie chahiye. How do I calculate? Kya utna mushkil hai calculate karna calories? Nahi hai. So first, it's very, very simple. First, find your body weight in kilograms. Now, how much? Suppose, for example, your body weight is, say, 50 kgs. Multiply your weight in kilograms by 0.9 if you're a woman and 1 if you're a man. Now, again, jo number aata hai, usko aap 24 se multiply kijiye. Or agar kahin aap, if you can find out your lean mass, lean mass is nothing but muscle content or the protein content in your body minus the fat. Fat nahi hona chahiye, that is lean mass. Agar is factor se aap usko multiply kar lo, to you will get your number of calories that you need to take in a given day. For example, yahan par jaise humne ek mere niece ke statistics diye gaye hain yahan par, like she's 61 kgs female, so maine unka multiply kiya 61 into 0.9. again ye figure ko maine multiply kiya 24 se aur unko multiply usko wo figure wo number ko maine multiply kiya uske lean mass se. तो उसके टोटल कैलोरीज निकले हैं 1252. नाउ ये तो बेस कैलोरी हो गया, जैसे हमने बीएमआर बोला है, दैट विल मेंटेन हर बॉडी जस्ट टू सर्वाइव, मतलब जिंदा रहने के लिए जो कैलोरीज चाहिए उतने काफी है 1250. उसके बाद ये कैलोरीज को आप एक्टिविटी फैक्टर जो हम बोलते हैं उससे मल्टीप्लाई करने चाहिए. व्हाट इज एन एक्टिविटी फैक्टर? एनीथिंग, जैसे यहाँ पर जो फॉर्मूला है उसको फॉलो कीजिए, लाइक 1.3 फॉर वेरी लाइट, मतलब मैं दिन में पूरा बैठे रहती हूँ, एडमिन काम करती हूँ, मतलब ज्यादा नहीं घूमती हूँ इधर उधर, देन डिवाइडेड बाय 1.3, दैट इज सिटिंग, जस्ट स्टडिंग, इधर उधर थोड़ा सा चल लेती हूँ, दैट इज 1.3. लाइट 1.55, सो जैसे थोड़ा सा, जैसे टीचर्स हैं आप, तो थोड़ा सा चलना फिरना होता है, थोड़ा चिल्लाना होता है, सिखाना होता है बच्चों को, या खड़ा होना होता है पूरा दिन, और थोड़ा सा आप चल भी लेते हो, देन दैट इज 1.55. थोड़ा सा अगर ज्यादा आप काम कर रहे हो तो 1.65. हैवी मैन्युअल लेबर्स जो काफी काम करते हैं तो उनको 1.80. एंड मॉडरेट टू हार्ड और एक्सट्रीम फिजिकल एक्टिविटी जो फॉर एग्जाम्पल एथलीट्स हो, या जहां पर बहुत बहुत ज्यादा फिजिकल वर्क काम किया जाता है, एक्सट्रीम लेबर जो करते हैं, उनको इनटू 2 आप मल्टीप्लाई करो, तो उसका जो टोटल कैलोरीज आता है, दैट इज द टोटल कैलोरीज दैट यू शुड बी टेकिंग इन अ गिवन डे. दिन में इतने कैलोरीज आपको लेने पड़े. नाउ ये एक लिस्ट है जहां पर इंडियन फूड्स हैं, जहां पर पूरे लिस्ट है कितना अप्रोक्सीमेटली बच्चों को खाने चाहिए और कितने कैलोरीज इसमें है. सो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. अगर आप दिन में ये सब अगर आप बना रहे हो तो ये लिस्ट में से आप देख सकते हो. अगर आप राइस बना रहे हो तो कितना, एक अगर कटोरी खा रहे हो तो कितने कैलोरी आएंगे. सपोज 2 कटोरी खा रहे हो तो जस्ट मल्टीप्लाइड इंटू 2. सो ऐसे आप ये लिस्ट में से आप पूरा जो आप खा रहे हो उसका आप एक लिस्ट पूरे दिन का बना लो. हम जैसे बोलते हैं 24 आवर रिकॉल डाइट, 24 आवर रिकॉल डाइट में आप क्या करना चाहिए, पेज ले लो, एक पेज लेके उसमें आप लिख लो कि दिन में सुबह से लेके रात तक आपने क्या खाया है और कितना खाया है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल रोटी खाई है, राइट 2. अगर आप दिन में 2 बार चावल खाए हो, कितना कटोरी खाए हो, 2 कटोरी इंटू 2. अगर आप एप्पल खाए हो, वन एप्पल लिख लो. देन अगर आप फॉर एग्जाम्पल एक बर्गर खाए हो तो राइट अ बर्गर, और एक समोसा खाए हो राइट अ बर्गर. उसके बाजू में ये कैलोरीज लिख लेना. सो टोटल कैलोरीज दिन में आपको आ जाएगा. तो ऑन एन एवरेज इफ यू डू इट फॉर 3 डेज आपको पता लग जाएगा कि आप अपना एवरेज कैलोरीज क्या है. सो कुछ लोगों का होगा 2000, कुछ लोगों का एक दिन 2000 आएगा आपको, एक दिन 1800 आएगा, एक दिन 2500 आएगा, डिपेंडिंग ऑन व्हाट फूड यू हैव ईटन ऑन दैट पर्टिकुलर डे. सो टेक एन एवरेज ऑफ दीज 3 डेज. तो दैट इज वॉट इज द एवरेज दैट विल बी नॉर्मली आपका इनटेक होगा, दैट इज योर नॉर्मल इनटेक. सो नाउ यू नो दिस इज योर कैलोरीज इन अ गिवन डे. ओके, सो फाइंड आउट वेदर यूर एक्सीडिंग योर कैलोरीज, और यूर ईटिंग बिलो योर कैलोरीज, और यूर ईटिंग जस्ट वॉट योर बॉडी रिक्वायर्स अलॉन्ग विथ योर एक्टिविटी फैक्टर. सो यू विल नो वेदर द कैलोरीज आर इनफ फॉर यू और नॉट. इफ यूर ओवर ईटिंग यू कैन रिड्यूस, इफ यूर ईटिंग लेस यू कैन टेक मोर. This a very comprehensive list, what very very simple list what we follow every day in our daily diet, जो आम घर पे बनता है, सभी इसमें लिखा हुआ है, very very simple to understand. कोई questions हो तो आप पूछ सकते हो at the end of the session. Very all the common foods are normally covered here. Now what do you do for simple lifestyle changes for children? Let's see what we can do for them. For the small children, okay, eat more protein. Protein foods. What are protein foods that help build muscle or lean mass in the body? If you have seen, if you have been part of fitness groups, agar aap fitness groups ke part ho, or you are related to any sporting activity, or you are very conscious about your weight. You must have heard this very, very commonly used term protein. Protein badao, increase your protein in the food. And very, very rightly said, the more the protein in the food or your daily intake, the more healthier your life is, especially as you go into old age. Children require it for growing. For growing, that is the most important nutrition, because all the growth that takes place is mainly because of the protein. The muscle that is formed in the body requires only protein to a large extent. The protein, what are protein foods? Protein foods are nothing but milk. As I explained earlier, it is milk, it is cheese, it is butter, it is eggs, chicken, any non-vegetarian like chicken, mutton, beef, pork, everything comes under protein. How much protein do I require? Normally for kids, you require 0.6 to 0.8 grams of protein. That is more than enough. Agar aap din mein itna cover karo, 0.6 to 0.8 grams of protein per day, then it is more than enough. You get adequate protein. So what does protein do? It builds muscle. It gives you immunity. It counteracts age-related muscle. It keeps you feeling full. Agar if you have noticed, the day you don't have protein in your food, like kabhi paneer miss kar diya, paneer is very very rich in protein, dals, lentils, rajma, soya bean, all these are extremely rich. Aajkal ek naya food aa raha hai, quinoa, kafi log le rahe hain, wo also extremely rich in protein. Millets hai, they are rich in proteins. So jaise aap jitna aap zyada protein aapke diet ya food ya plate mein hoga, उतना आपकी मतलब जल्दी भूख नहीं लगेगी. यू विल नॉट फील हंग्री. तो दैट सटाइटी जो पेट को भरने की फीलिंग है, प्रोटीन विल गिव यू, एंड इट विल कीप यू फुल फॉर अ वेरी लॉन्ग टाइम. एंड स्टॉप दिस स्नैकिंग इन बिटवीन मील्स. ये स्नैकिंग, जो छोटे छोटे स्नैक की जो आदत है वो कम कर देगी. इट इंक्रीजेस योर मेटाबॉलिक रेट. जैसे हमने पहले डिस्कस किया था कि बॉडी को डाइजेस्ट, फूड डाइजेस्ट करने के लिए भी एनर्जी चाहिए. सो प्रोटीन डाइजेस्ट करने के लिए बॉडी को काफी एनर्जी चाहिए, और ये आपके वेट को मेंटेन करेगा. स्पीड्स इंजरी रिकवरी टाइम. प्रोटीन, जैसे आपको पता है, मसल जो है या रिकवरी के लिए प्रोटीन की मात्रा बहुत बहुत जरूरी है। जितना हाई प्रोटीन डाइट में उतनी मसल रिकवरी बहुत फास्ट होती है। सो छोटे छोटे इंजुरीज होते हैं उसके लिए बहुत बहुत जरूरी है। चिल्ड्रन के लिए ग्रोथ में जो होता है प्रोटीन इज एक्सट्रीमली इम्पॉर्टेंट एज अ मैक्रोन्यूट्रिएंट, इनफैक्ट द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट कम्पेयर टू द अदर टू मैक्रोन्यूट्रिएंट्स। एंड ऑल्सो फॉर थ्री सेगमेंट्स आई वुड रेकमेंड चिल्ड्रन, एथलीट्स, एनीबडी हु इज इनटू स्पोर्ट्स एंड ऑल्सो वुमेन। वुमेन रिक्वायर लॉट ऑफ प्रोटीन। हाउ मच प्रोटीन डू यू रिक्वायर, यू शुड कैलकुलेट बेस्ड ऑन द रिकमेंडेड डायट्री अलाउंस। वो आपको इजिली कोई भी बुक में मिल जाता है। एज आई सजेस्टेड 0.6 टू 0.8 ग्राम्स पर केजी बॉडी वेट, दैट इज द मिनिमम दैट यू रिक्वायर। एंड डोंट लोड अप ऑन प्रोटीन एट वंस, डिवाइड इट बिटवीन मील्स। सो इफ यू रिक्वायर से अबाउट 40 ग्राम्स ऑफ प्रोटीन, आप 15 टू 20 ग्राम्स सुबह खा लेना एंड 15 टू 20 ग्राम्स रात को रख लेना, या 10 ग्राम्स इन द मॉर्निंग, 10 ग्राम्स इन द आफ्टरनून। सो स्प्रेड आउट योर प्रोटीन इन, डोंट लोड अप एट अ सिंगल टाइम। एंड ईटिंग प्रोटीन थ्रू आउट द डे, ओके, थ्रू आउट द डे। आपने एसेंशियल अमाइनो एसिड सुना होगा। सो थ्रू आउट द डे व्हेन यू कीप ईटिंग इट, विद द प्रोटीन इन द बॉडी इज कंटिन्यूअसली रिलीज्ड लाइक अ स्लो रिलीजिंग मेडिसिन एंड इट हेल्प्स यू टू रिकवर वेरी फास्ट। Especially, if you have heard of casein protein that is found in milk, if you take a glass of milk at night and sleep, or you have a little paneer at night, it gives you a lot of milk protein that is casein, which is a slow acting protein. So, pura raat aapke body mein wo kaam karte rahega and it will help your muscle recover. So, very tired, you can have a glass of milk and sleep, and that casein protein will help you recover very, very fast for the next day. Now, how do I help children develop eating habits? So easy to talk, children ye kha lo, bache ye kha lo. So easy to talk. But do they listen to you? And how do I make the food interesting? That is a very important question all women ask. How do I do it? Now, eat a different variety of fruit and vegetables per day, both raw and cooked. Now, some people get attracted, as we call it, you eat first with the eyes. How do I eat with the eyes first? Because I should like the food what I'm eating. If I see colored fruits, I like color red. So if I keep some strawberries there for food, or I keep a mango there for a yellow bright color, or I keep say bright tomatoes. So if I add color to my food, I will love my salads if I want to eat salads. So make sure your food is very, very attractive. That is one way of making people eat food, especially children. Children get very attracted to innovative foods. Children get attracted to color of the food. So don't add external colors. Try to make it more colorful fruits and vegetables. So if you're making a salad, say a plain salad with vegetables, try adding a little fruits. Actually, pineapple is added in most salads. Apples are added. So if you add all the fruits or vegetables what the child likes, that will make them interesting to eat. For example, if you are making ladies finger or jaise paneer bana rahe ho, palak paneer bana rahe ho, try to retain the color a little so that it is attractive to the child to pick up and eat. Now how many vegetables and fruits that I require in a given day, kitna serving chahiye, kya main din bhar sirf fruits and vegetables khate rahu? नहीं, अकॉर्डिंग टू द एज, फॉर एग्जाम्पल योर एज, चाइल्ड का एज है 1 to 2 years, ओके, सो नॉर्मली वी गिव फ्रूट्स, सॉफ्ट फ्रूट्स फ्रॉम 1 to 2 years, लाइक बनानाज आर रेकमेंडेड, एप्पल्स आर रेकमेंडेड, फॉर ऑरेंजेस आर रेकमेंडेड। सो फॉर गर्ल्स एंड बॉयज इट्स द सेम, 1 to 2 फ्रूट्स इन अ डे, वेजिटेबल्स 2 to 3 सर्विंग्स, एंड फॉर बॉयज ऑल्सो 2 to 3 सर्विंग्स। अगर आप देखो बॉयज की एज द एज गोज अप, बॉयज की थोड़ी सी इनटेक जो है उसकी रेकमेंडेड इनटेक गोज अप, थोड़ी सी ज्यादा होने लगती है, क्योंकि बॉयज की रिक्वायरमेंट, फिजिकल रिक्वायरमेंट इज वेरी वेरी हाई कंपेयर टू द गर्ल्स। इफ यू लुक एट 9 टू 11 एंड 12 टू 18 एज में बॉयज की ग्रोथ स्पर्ट बहुत हाई होती है कंपेयर टू द गर्ल्स। एंड व्हेन यू एक्चुअली कंपेयर देयर फूड इनटेक, बॉयज का इनटेक बहुत ज्यादा होता है, गर्ल्स टेंड टू थोड़ा सा निग्लेक्ट करती है फूड। तो गर्ल्स को थोड़ा सा पर्टिकुलर इंटरेस्ट होना पड़ता है एंड गर्ल्स के लिए फॉर एग्जाम्पल आप 9 to 11 या थोड़ा सा 12 या 13 या 14 तक जाओगे तो मीन आर्क शुरू हो जाता है, बॉयज के लिए प्यूबर्टी शुरू हो जाती है. तो दैट इज द मैक्सिमम ग्रोथ स्पर्ट ड्यूरिंग दैट टाइम. एंड ये ग्रोथ स्पर्ट के टाइम में आपको ये यू हैव टू बी वेरी वेरी केयरफुल दैट यू पिक अप लॉट ऑफ फ्रूट्स एंड वेजिटेबल्स टू गिव देम लॉट ऑफ इम्यूनिटी एंड मेक द फूड इंटरेस्टिंग फॉर देम टू ईट दिस दिस सेगमेंट ऑफ फूड. Lot of adolescent kids, in fact even toddlers prefer drinking beverages with added sugars like Coke, Pepsi, Sprite हो या milkshakes आजकल जो भी मिलते हो. तो ये very very common, especially while they are watching TV. They tend to drink without any limit. Sometimes एक या दो bottles पी लेते हैं. They also have a tendency to have a drink before aa raha hai kya guys, video is not children have a tendency to drink lot of पानी पी लेते हैं ग्लास या शुगरी ड्रिंक्स पी लेते हैं जस्ट बिफोर हैविंग अ मील, जस्ट खाना खाने के पहले एक बॉटल कोक पी लेते हैं. तो ये अवॉइड करना चाहिए. मिल्क शेक्स, लॉट ऑफ मिल्क शेक्स जो बाहर मार्केट में अवेलेबल है कंटेन लॉट ऑफ शुगर्स. सो एज फार एज पॉसिबल ट्राई टू मेक देम एट होम. कभी कभी जो फूड आपको सुपर मार्केट्स में मिल जाते हैं, आजकल हर जगह छोटे छोटे दुकान में भी मिल जाते हैं, स्मॉल शॉप्स यू गेट, दे स्पेसिफिकली मेंशन लो शुगर नो फैट. बट प्लीज रीड द लेबल वेरी वेरी केयरफुली बिकॉज द लेबल्स आर मिसलीडिंग. नो शुगर डज नॉट मीन देर इज नो फ्रक्टोज सिरप इन दैट. लेबल पढ़ना बहुत जरूरी है. लॉट ऑफ टू जस्ट टू मेक इट टेस्टी दे ऐड लॉट ऑफ सिरप्स इन दैट. And they mention it as no sugar. So a lot of cheap brands do that. So be careful what you pick up from the supermarket as well. Read the label very, very carefully. Now, what are the healthy choices that children can have as far as possible? Make the juice at home. If it is not possible due to time constraints or affordability or whatever, try to eat one or two fruits, whole fruits, rather than giving fruit juices, because fruit juices strip the fruit of its fiber. So preferably have a fruit. So water, fruit infused fruit. आजकल आप सभी के टेबल पर देखते हो बड़े बड़े बॉटल्स होते हैं with lot of cut fruits in that. So that is a fruit infused water which you can easily make at home. Children also find it very interesting to eat to drink a different type of water. So every day change the fruit. So one day add lime, one day add oranges in that. Just cut the fruits and put it in the water and keep. And let them drink it. So pineapple is a good option. Watermelons are a good option. If you get berries, I don't know how many places you get berries. Berries is a good option. So those are things that you can just add to the this thing. Skim or 1% milk. Milk is anyway for children. You can give whole milk. You don't have to worry about skim milk unless they are extremely obese. So milk is a good. It's a wholesome. Pura nutrition milk mein aa jata hai. Light. टी जो है लाइट टी ग्रीन टी जैसे जो हम बोलते हैं वो दे सकते हैं. अनस्वीटेंड टी काफी लोगों को आदत होता है चाय पीना बहुत बार चाय पीना. सो अनस्वीटेंड टी इज फाइन. शुगर लोडेड टी इज नॉट फाइन. नाउ दैट इज द ग्रीन जैसे ग्रीन चॉइसेस में हमने डाला है वहां पर. येलो और मॉडरेटली हेल्दी चॉइस कैन बी अ चॉकलेट मिल्क. चॉकलेट मिल्क इज नॉट बैड. वी वुडंट कॉल अ चॉकलेट मिल्क बैड. उसका टाइमिंग भी होता है जैसे दिन में एक बार चॉकलेट मिल्क थोड़ा सा कम शुगर के साथ पियो तो इट इज वेरी वेरी गुड. एनी लो कैलोरी स्पोर्ट्स ड्रिंक्स एस्पेशली इफ यू आर रिलेटेड टू स्पोर्ट्स और हॉबी स्पोर्ट्स लो कैलोरी स्पोर्ट्स ड्रिंक्स और इफ द चाइल्ड इज गोइंग फॉर एनी ड्यूरिंग एनी फिजिकल ट्रेनिंग और एक्सरसाइजिंग लो कैलोरी स्पोर्ट्स ड्रिंक्स आर एडवाइजेबल. 100% जूस इज एडवाइजेबल माइनस द शुगर. जूसेज आर एक्सट्रीमली हेल्दी. ऑरेंज जूस वाटरमेलन जूस एनी जूस. Diet soda, although thoda sa I would go a little slow on that. Diet soda is fine, but not for children. It is fine for adults. above 18. Now, least healthy choices that are in red are sports drinks that are highly sugared, any energy drinks, again, because of the sugar, regular soda, fruit drinks with added sugar. Aajkal jo market mein milta hai aapko, whatever you get in market, packed juices, they are extremely high in fructose syrup. It's called as HC, high corn fructose syrup, HCFS. So please try to avoid that as much as possible. And sweetened tea. Zyada chai mat pijiye. Unsweetened tea is fine as far as possible. Lot of cultures mein jo hai black tea, patan chai to bolte hain hum yahan par, ya Suleimani chai, black tea, ya black coffee. They are all very, very good. Now, jaise niche mentioned hai, aap pad sakte ho, added sugar has no nutritional value. Usme sirf carbs milte hain, with zero nutrition. So as far as possible, reduce your sugar intake unless it is required. Drinking large amounts of sugar can cause a lot of weight. Very easily you can put on weight because of the sugars. And weight gain can lead to a person being overweight or obese. Normally, children, hum jab ki diet recall lete hain, koi obese children ya overweight children ko, main hamare paas jo recall mein aata hai, sugary foods. They are cool drinks, any carbonated beverages, cakes, muffins, and burgers and puffs. They are the main culprits of weight gain, especially in children. And they normally obese children who do not learn good eating habits continue in their adulthood, continue to grow fat and continue to grow obese. So it is important to inculcate all these habits in children in their growth stage itself so that they rectify and go into adulthood with a healthy body. Reduce your carb intake. So why do we say reduce your carb intake? What is carbohydrate? Carbohydrates comes from cereals like rice, wheat, millets. Some amount of dal also adds to carbohydrates. A lot of dals add to carb. Like rajma is very, very high in carbohydrate as well as fat, although it has very high protein. So all these are very, very rich in carbohydrates. But it is important to make sure which to avoid and which not to avoid. For example, rice is a very good carbohydrate. It has a lot of complex starches or complex carbohydrates, as we call it. Wheat is good carbohydrate. What is a not good carbohydrate? Like refined flours, like maida, is a not good carbohydrate, as we call it. So you have to differentiate what is a good carbohydrate, what is a not good carbohydrate. So avoid foods that are made with refined flours like maida. For example, puffs are made extremely with maida. Some parathas or naans are made with paratha, with maida. So try to use a lot of whole wheat foods as a form of carbohydrate. Rotis, whole wheat atta is very good, not the maida atta. So try to avoid breads as much as possible. Breads are normally usually made with maida or refined flour. Lot of children like bread. Literally, din mein pura din, if you give them bread, they will continue to eat. Eat in extreme moderation. Don't make it a habit. Sandwich is a very good way of eating food or adding vegetables to your diet. But make sure that sandwiches are not an everyday habit. Kabhi kabar aap bread ko roti se aap usko substitute kar dijiye. So that bread intake is very less. Now, eating a low-carb diet. Why do we recommend a low-carb diet? Because it maintains normal blood sugar in the body. Just insulin levels. The moment you start eating, like we wake up in the morning and eat a cup of tea or a biscuit, immediately, like in North India, there are a lot of habits with tea. With biscuit or tea. Maharashtra mein toast dubate hain, Parle Ji biscuits dubate hain, very, very common habits. Ya pav dubate hain. The moment you do that, aapke insulin levels bad jate hain, they tend to push the sugars in your cells and improve your glycogen. But itna bhi nahi khana hai ki aapke sugar levels high rahe, so that it gets converted to fat. Now, low calorie or high carb diets versus low carb diets. So, high, जैसे sugar levels ऊपर जाते हैं और एकदम नीचे होते हैं. if it's a low carb high protein diets as we call it, आपके शुगर लेवल स्टेडी होते हैं काफी देर तक, और काफी देर तक आपको भूख नहीं लगती है. लो कैलोरी या हाई कार्ब डाइट जो होता है दे इंक्रीज फैट स्टोरेज और हंगर जो है जल्दी आती है. जितना आप प्रोटीन या लो कार्ब रखो उतना आपकी भूख बहुत धीरे से आएगी, तो नेक्स्ट मील आप बहुत थोड़े देर के बाद खाओगे. नाउ हाउ डू आई मेंटेन दिस डेली डाइट, हाउ डू आई मेंटेन अ प्रॉपर हेल्दी डाइट? So add more fruits and vegetables. If you can see how many colors of fruits and vegetables are here, the most colorful slide that I can see here is this today because of the fruits and vegetables that are present here. But ek hai mixed veggies into all your dishes. Try to put veggies. Aajkal kafi I wouldn't call it fashion again, but kafi healthy habits shuru hua hai. Like idli mein vegetables dalte hain. When you steam idlis, they add vegetables. They add vegetables in dosas. Khichdi jo hai, hum jo normally kafi vegetables usme daliye. So this is some of the simple ways to improve your veggie intake. Parathe jo bante hain, gobi ke parathe bante, aalu ke parathe bante. So try to put lot of vegetables, different vegetables. Se aap experiment kar sakte hain. Swap meat for peppers and mushrooms. So जहाँ पर आप red meat daily खाते हो, और जैसे mutton जो है red meat में आता है, so don't make it a habit of eating red meat every day because it contains a lot of fat. Although it's very good for your body, once or twice a week is more than enough. Try to eat more of white meat. Veggie pasta जो है instead of grain pasta, जो refined pasta से है, उससे मत खाइए pasta या noodles. Try to source. Wherever possible, try to source pasta or noodles made of wheat or different grains. Aajkal aasani se, if you can afford it, aajkal aasani se online ya supermarket se mil jata hai. I remember traditionally also, they used to make lot of noodles with wheat, which was available easily in villages and rural areas. I don't know if the same practice is there in urban areas. Whenever possible, वॉच फॉर सोडियम. मिल्क सॉल्ट जो है जैसे सॉसेस में होता है या कैंड फूड प्रोडक्ट्स में होता है, पिकल्स में होता है, तो सोडियम थोड़ा सा आप मॉडरेशन में रखिए, कम खाइए. लुक फॉर कैंड फूड पैक्ड इन वाटर इंस्टेड ऑफ सिरप. सो प्लेन वाटर जो मिल सकता है इंस्टेड ऑफ, अगर मेरे को ओशन वाटर रहा वहां पर या कोक रहा तो आई विल पिक अप द ओशन वाटर. सो ज्यादातर जहाँ पर शुगर ना हो ऐसे आप लिक्विड्स या फ्लूइड इंटेक कीजिए. Pack your child's lunch bag. Very, very important meal of the day. They have it with friends there. So whenever you are packing a lunch, see that it is healthy. Thoda sa, agar sliced apples aap nahi dal paoge, that's a good way of giving them fruits. Agar sliced ek banana dal dijiye, ya give them a carrot to munch on. Just cut kar ek salad ki tarah aap wahan laga dijiye. Normally ghar pe salads nahi khate hain bache, but अगर फ्रेंड्स के साथ एक ग्रुप के साथ होते हैं तो दे जस्ट मंच इट बिकॉज़ उनको भूख लग रहा है स्कूल में. सो थोड़ा सा मंचिंग हैबिट फ्रूट्स या वेजिटेबल्स के ऊपर से आप वो हैबिट आप उनको इंकल्केट कीजिए. प्रिपेयर हेल्दी स्नैक्स. टीच चिल्ड्रन टू डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन एवरीडे स्नैक्स. अगर आप समोसा की तरफ जा रहे हैं एवरीडे या बज्जी जैसे बनते हैं, पकौड़े बनते हैं या पफ्स खाते हैं, ये सब अवॉइड कीजिए जहां तक हो सके. ट्राई टू मेक डिफरेंट हेल्दी स्नैक्स विच आर इंटरेस्टिंग टू द किड्स. हम लोग जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल यहाँ पर हम लोग ना पोहा बनाते हैं शाम को, थोड़ा सा लाइट सा पोहा देते हैं विद अ लिटिल ऑफ जैगरी एंड विद अ लिटिल ऑफ पीनट्स इन दैट. और हम लोग जैसे साउथ इंडिया में सुंडल बोलते हैं, जैसे चने को भिगा कर उसका थोड़ा सा लाइट उसको गार्निश करके हम लोग बॉइल्ड चना दे देते हैं. नॉर्थ में भी देयर इज अ हैबिट ऑफ ईटिंग बॉइल्ड चना या बॉइल्ड पीनट्स. सो दीज आर वेरी गुड एग्जांपल्स ऑफ स्नैक्स. नॉट मेनी चिल्ड्रन ईट इट, बट ट्राई टू मेक इट अ लिटिल इंटरेस्टिंग टू मेक देम ग्रैब. इवन इफ दे ग्रैब अ फिस्टफुल ऑल्सो इट इज इनफ. यू डोंट हैव टू मेक इट प्लेट में दो या उसका एक यू डोंट हैव टू मेक इट लाइक अ सेरेमनी, ये खाना ही खाना है. नहीं, स्लोली स्लोली I have seen with children, जितना आप उनको force करेंगे उतना वो rebel करेंगे खाने में. तो try to make it very interesting one. And अगर नहीं खा रहे हैं एक दो दिन छोड़ दीजिए, but make sure you keep it on the table and don't give an alternative to them. So धीरे धीरे they will start developing a taste for it. Now keep cut fruits and vegetables like carrots, peppers, कभी भी एक्सेसिबल रखिए फ्रूट्स एंड वेजिटेबल्स सो दैट व्हेनेवर द चाइल्ड वांट्स टू ईट ही कैन ईट. नॉट मेनी पीपल हैव द हैबिट ऑफ पीलिंग द फ्रूट्स, उसको काट के खाना. नॉट मेनी चिल्ड्रन विल डू इट. सो इफ पॉसिबल कीप इट कट एंड रेडी एंड हैंडी फॉर देम टू ईट एंड प्रिपेयर योर मील्स फॉर अ वीक अहेड. प्लान योर मील्स सो दैट आप वीकेंड में उनके साथ टाइम स्पेंड करो, और जब भी आप उनके साथ टाइम स्पेंड करते हो, make it a habit to talk to them about healthy food. And more importantly, one message should go that I eat healthy, so children look at you as an example when you eat healthy. If you eat junk, they will eat junk. If you eat healthy, wo sochenge ek baar nahi ya dusre baar sochenge, why are they the adults or the parents in our house eating this and not eating this? There must be a reason. So वो हैबिट या वो एग्जाम्पल आप सेट कीजिए, ओनली देन दे विल फॉलो. जैसे ब्रेकफास्ट में ओट्स है, आजकल ओट्स खाते हैं, ओट्स इज अ वेरी वेरी गुड ब्रेकफास्ट टू हैव. सो मेक सिंपल ब्रेकफास्ट, यू डोंट हैव टू मेक इट वेरी कॉम्प्लिकेटेड. इंडियन ब्रेकफास्ट काफी हेल्दी है, जैसे साउथ इंडिया में जैसे पोंगल इडली डोसा है, नॉर्थ इंडिया में पराठा है, गुजरात हैज लॉट ऑफ हेल्दी बेसन रिलेटेड या ग्राम फ्लोर से जो ब्रेकफास्ट बनता है प्रीटी हेल्दी. सो पिकअप फ्रॉम दैट. And have north east में जैसे सुबह सुबह राइस खाते हैं, fermented राइस खाते हैं, it's a very very good habit. सुबह सुबह आपको probiotic loaded complex starches मिल रहे हैं, an extremely good habit to start. So the overall balanced diet of food that we eat every day is the main thing. Reduce fat, reduce sugar, and reduce salt. Don't avoid it, but the word that is important is reduce. Reduction is important. Avoidance is not required. So when eating out, aajkal bahut log bahar khate hain, eating out choose baked or grilled food instead of fried. So har jagah baked or grilled nahi milega. As far as possible, make healthy choices whenever you are going out, especially when you are eating often. Make sure you eat healthy. Once in a while, if you eat and you indulge, it is fine. But if you are agar bahar khane ki aadat bahut hai, so try to eat healthy. Make water to go your drink instead of soda, instead of cokes and koi sweetened beverages. As I mentioned earlier, keep drinking a lot of water. Read labels on packages. Kabhi bhi label padke aap select karna food. Lot of all of us have a tendency, especially children, food ko bahut attract karte hain. एडवर्टाइजमेंट की ये खा लो, इसमें लो शुगर है. चिल्ड्रन की ग्रोथ दिखाते हैं वो, अगर ये आप पी लो डेली, इफ यू हैव दिस एवरी डे आपकी ग्रोथ बहुत अच्छी होगी. ये सब आप अवॉइड कीजिए. फॉर एग्जाम्पल आप कॉम्प्लान ले सकते हो, हॉर्लिक्स ले सकते हो, ऑल्दो दे आर वेरी वेरी गुड ड्रिंक्स. इट इज गुड फॉर पीपल हु आर एनर्जी डेफिशियंट. बट अगर आप घर का खाना पूरा खा रहे हो तो ये सब ड्रिंक्स की कोई जरूरत नहीं है. Because they are loaded with sugar. If you just put a spoonful of that thing in your milk, it adds a lot of sugar to your milk. So try to avoid that as much as possible. Ghar ka jo plain milk hai, that is more than enough. Now reduce amounts of salt when you are adding to the food, because food mein already thoda sa salt hota hai. As far as possible, just add minimum that is required to taste or for your palate to understand there is namak in the food or there is salt in the food. Control portion sizes. Again, you can eat everything. You can eat a pizza also. You can eat a burger also. But portion sizes is important. What is a portion size? Kitna aapke pet ko kitna bas hai utna hi khao. Don't indulge or don't overload yourself with food. Agar pizza kha rahe ho, ek piece khao, do piece khao. Don't yaar do piece aur bach gaya, let me eat it. To ye mat kijiye. Portion sizes mein aap khaiye. That is enough. King size lunch, beggar size dinner जैसे बोलते हैं. Start your day with a healthy, heavy breakfast. Have a moderate lunch. Dinner up, keep it light, and don't overeat. That is the mantra of a balanced diet, of a good lifestyle. Do not overeat. Now, how many? These are the recommended dietary allowances for boys and girls. For example. If you've seen the age, थोड़ा सा अलग है boys और girls के लिए. Body weight, if you see the total calories that are required, protein is pretty high. Protein बहुत मुश्किल से मिलता है खाने में, very very difficult to get protein in the diet unless you're adding an animal protein. As far as possible, try to include animal protein in your everyday diet. Ek portion animal protein डालिए. प्रोटीन जो एनिमल से मिलते हैं दैट इज बेस्ट अब्सॉर्ब्ड इन द बॉडी. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट यू हैव फैट, विजिबल फैट एंड इनविजिबल फैट. विजिबल फैट इज द ऑयल दैट यू ऐड, इनविजिबल फैट इज व्हाट इज ऑलरेडी प्रेजेंट इन द फूड. दिस आर सम ऑफ द रिकमेंडेशंस फॉर चिल्ड्रन. ट्राई टू मेंटेन दिस बॉडी वेट. अगेन, बॉडी वेट इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट, द हेल्थ ऑफ द चाइल्ड इज इम्पॉर्टेंट. सो एज अ मदर, एज अ टीचर, as a physical education practitioner, you will be able to see whether the child is healthy or not. Don't go by the norms or the usual norms. As long as the child is healthy, active, and within the range, that is more than enough. Now, sleeping time is very, very important. So whenever we take a diet recall or a dietary modification, we also see how much time a child is sleeping. For example, 1 to 3 जो क्लास में है, they require about 9 hours of sleeping. So 9 study time, 1 hour. ये पूरा हम calculate करके ही हम बोलते हैं कि इतने time हमको सोने के लिए चाहिए. But lot of जो सोने का time है, sleeping time है, is impacted either by TV or mobile phone. Or अभी जो online classes चल रहे हैं, you can't blame the child sometimes because of the online classes. There are a lot of times when a child is seeing TV or mobile time. So इसको आप थोड़ा सा reduce कीजिए, because it also affects the sleep time. So as you know, the growth hormone, that is the human growth hormone that is produced in the body, is the highest when we are sleeping. So when you don't sleep, the growth hormone is reduced and the child's activities as well as the growth is impacted to a certain extent. So try to explain this to the kid. They will not listen because they're so addicted to mobile time. That is something that everybody has to take care of. So try to inculcate or introduce them to some hobbies that they like, especially singing, dancing, or reading is a habit that not many children have nowadays. So try to improve that. Or main exercise which I feel most children are excited about is sports. They go out and enjoy with their friends. So try to push them to go outside the house and enjoy with their kids, especially during this COVID time, since thoda sa activity level will keep them a little healthy, of course, maintaining social distance. And whenever the pandemic is over or we are free to interact with our peer group or a social group, try to inculcate more sports into your exercise related activities. That will help them to keep them active. So raat ko thoda thak ke jaldi so jayenge. Sleeping is very important. Right posture for sitting. So this is also very, very important. How we slouch when we are sitting on a desk, especially abhi online jaise classes ho rahe hain bachcho ke liye. So make sure they keep their spine straight and keep their body posture correctly and maintain, because long hours of sitting will impact their health, and they tend to droop over a period of time. As jaise wo aadat ho jati hai body ko, wo droop unko body mein dikhna shuru ho jata hai. So as far as possible, try to sit straight and don't sit for long times. Keep moving around a little so that then you come back and sit. So thoda sa activity level thoda sa badh jayega bachon ke liye. Child's backpack, again, very, very important issue. Lot of children's bags are overloaded with books. See that, go and talk to the school if possible to reduce their books, or that also impacts the posture when the child bends and walks for a long distance. Agar school 1 kilometer, 2 kilometers door hai, and the child is walking with a backpack, that makes it very heavy. So see that when they're walking, try to make them aware that, jahan tak ho sake, keep observing how they walk. If they're slouching, keep telling them to walk straight. And they will understand why they have a lot of back problems later on in life are due to carrying heavy back loads with incorrect posture. Water, maine already discussed kiya hai, but I will repeat. Because very, very important nutrient apart from all the macro and the micronutrients, how much water should you drink? The kgs that you have divided by 2. Suppose I am 50 kgs, I will require about 2 liters of water, 2 to 2.5 liters of water. So what are the reasons that you drink more, you should drink more water? Of course, the most important reason is most carbonated beverages, you spend a lot of money. What is the most cheapest and the healthiest form of drink that you can ever have? It improves your skin condition, lubricates your body, flushes out toxins, especially summer mein, requirement goes up, try to drink more water and try to keep yourself hydrated. It boosts immunity also, and jab bhi aapko headache aur jab bhi aapko bhook lage, please drink a glass of water before. Sometimes thirst mimics hunger. So aap bhook lag rahi hai to ye mat soche ki aapko bhook lag rahi hai. Drink a glass of water and then wait for 15 minutes. If you're still feeling hungry, then it is hunger. Otherwise, you are just feeling thirsty. So how do you know if you're hydrated? Urine is a very good example to know whether you're hydrated or not. Har ek ek ya do ghante ko ek baar to bhi, agar if you're not visiting the washroom for peeing or for urination, that means your water intake is not adequate. One. Two, check the urine color. If it is pale light or whitish, it is fine. Or pale light yellow is fine. But if you are getting a dark yellow colored urine and the urine frequency, urination frequency is very less, then that means the water content, water intake needs to be improved or increased. Now, these are some of the healthy habits. You have to reflect, replace, reinforce, as we call it. All your habits reflect. आपने अभी तक जो जो भी किया है, what habits that you have been following, whether they are right or wrong, please keep reflecting it. Unhealthy eating habits with replace unhealthy eating habits. Like for example, if you're eating a lot of junk chips, try to replace it with healthier options like fruit chips or baked chips rather than fried chips. Try to start new healthier habits. As again I mentioned before, you are as adults, we are examples of for children. They look up to us and they will follow our examples. So stay fit, stay healthy, stay energized, and stay safe. Just to summarize what we spoke in all these slides, make small, subtle dietary changes. You don't have to make major changes every time. Start with small changes. Include loads of fruits and vegetables in your diet. Reduce unhealthy carbohydrates and fats. Make lifestyle changes. Correct your posture, especially for children, and hydrate yourself more often. If you follow these 4 to 5 month simple mantras in your life, it will be a very good, healthy lifestyle change that you take into adulthood. Thank you very much.
Thank you, madam. Very, very nice. Very, very informative presentation this was. Can you stop that slide, madam? Slide share. Stop sharing. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
For this whole sessions, madam, today is a day where so many questions have arisen.
Oh my goodness. Yeah.
I think to answer these questions, you may need another 2 sessions. This one session is not sufficient, but still 1 or 2 questions, please, madam. Madam, one question is that how much nutrition needed per day, they're asking. Per day.
How much nutrition you require per day?
Per day, yes, ma'am.
It depends on the age of the person. It depends again on the activity factor of the person, the already existing health of the person. For example, children require very high nutrition. as adults, when we go into adulthood, we require less quantity of macronutrients and more quantity of micronutrients. But for children, you require both in very, very high quantity. So nutrition, when I say nutrition, it again differs from person to person. Make sure whenever you're having a proper balanced diet, अगर आपके प्लेट में वो जो पांच चीजें मैंने जो मेंशन किया है वो सब है, that means you are getting a proper nutrition in your food. So see that three times your plate contains all these substances or food groups that were mentioned in the slides.
Madam, still some more questions. We'll go it very faster. Which food is beneficial for a bone development, madam?
For bone development, most importantly, calcium and vitamin D. A lot of us are deficient in vitamin D. What you can do is egg yolks are very rich in vitamin D. So please don't throw egg yolks. Egg yolks kha lijiye. For vegetarians, paneer and milk are very good for calcium and both vitamin D as well.
Madam, consent to this bone development. Many suggestions are there that even sunlight, early morning sunlight is also very good.
Yes.
So what sort of vitamins we may get from that?
Right now, only vitamin D. But thing is, there is a specific time to expose yourself to sunlight, not the whole day. Sometimes late evenings are very, very harmful. So approximately between 10 and 12 is a very good way of getting good intake of vitamin D. Sometimes early in the morning also when you are exercising. Normally vitamin D works, your absorption works very well during your exercise. So that is why we tell you to come out in the morning sun and exercise so that you don't get harmful rays also, as well as you get in your exercise also.
Thank you, ma'am. Suggestions are like every time there is a controversy, veg and non-veg. So which one is a good food they are asking?
There is nothing like veg is good or non-veg is good. Please see what suits your body. There are a lot of people who have vegetarian food and have a lot of deficiencies in their body. There are a lot of non-vegetarians also who are unhealthy. So there is nothing like this is good or this is bad. Please understand whatever your body requires, please have it. There has been no published literature as of now which says vegetarian is good or non-vegetarian is good.
And I'm concerned to this nutrition, B12. They say that this nutrition is available only in non-veg.
Yes, yes.
So how a vegetarian can get this one, whether that is produced within our body or we have to get from which sort of food in vegetarian for vegetarians?
Yeah, B12, lot of vegetarians have deficiencies because B12 normally, usually you get it only from non-vegetarian foods. But there is another way of getting B12 for vegetarians. If you have heard of probiotics, that is the intestinal bacteria that is present in the gut. So that produces a lot of B12. So make sure you have a lot of curd to develop that bacteria. Also have a lot of complex starches like fruits and vegetables that will help the bacteria grow in the gut to give you that particular B12 nutrition that is required in the intestine. Apart from that, if you still feel you're deficient, get your levels checked. If you're still deficient, I would suggest take a B12 supplement once in a while to make up for those levels.
Madam, what will be the recommendation of viewers or a suggestion towards the rural areas where malnutritions are very high? Especially in schools, we find this type of things. So what will be your suggestions?
Yeah, in rural areas, or if you have noticed midday meals, how they have developed because the cost of the food is less and the nutrition value is high. There are a lot of foods that are available, where it is not expensive, but the volume of nutrition is high. Like for example, you are looking at millet khichdi, which is very, very healthy. You don't require expensive foods. Just understand which foods are healthy, like a combination of rice and dal in khichdi, or a paratha that is loaded with vegetables and fruits, any roti. Those are very good examples of low-cost foods and highly nutritious.
Thank you, ma'am. Madam, at present, many people, even doctors also, suggest to have the supplements also. Whether these supplements really affects the absorption of vitamins?
again, if you are having a proper balanced diet within the calorie that is mentioned, you do not require any supplements. Okay, you are just spending your money. Okay, if you are not able to get certain foods, for example, you're not able to eat a proper balanced diet, then you can add a supplement wherever deficiency is there. For example, if you have got checked for an iron deficiency, and if it is acute iron deficiency, try to include more iron foods and also take a supplement so that your levels go up. If you are having a vitamin D deficiency, try to include vitamin D foods like milk or eggs or whatever. And then if you still feel you're deficient and if your levels are not coming up, only then take a supplement. As far as possible, try to get the levels up with natural food. Do not go for supplements unless it's required.
Madam, one question is arised here. They are asking like a suggestion for a breast cancer patient. What sort of diet they have to prefer?
Normally for breast cancer patient, breast cancer patient, we avoid trying giving estrogen producing foods. For example, cruciferous vegetables that contain like cauliflower, broccoli, those are avoided. Soya bean is avoided for breast cancer patients. So just may which stimulate the estrogen in your body, those foods should be avoided. Soya bean nuggets that you get, Nutella nuggets, are totally avoided. Any cruciferous vegetables are totally avoided. Cabbage, cauliflower, those things are avoided. But other than that, there is no reason to stop anything.
Thank you, ma'am. Question is that when age increases, near the joints, even accumulation of uric acid can be observed, they are saying. So at that time, how can we control this one? They say that because of protein, these type of things may increase. So how to control this? Just by avoiding protein contents that is sufficient, or they have to prefer exercise also to reduce that one?
One, exercise, nobody can deny. It is a very good way of reducing uric acid. Two, if the uric acid levels are very high, only then reduce your protein. Depends on the levels of uric acid. Suppose it goes up above 5-6 or it reaches around 8-9, only then you reduce or totally stop protein for some time. But make sure you have that minimum amount of protein, just that minimum amount to keep you healthy. Totally don't avoid protein. 1 egg or 2 eggs a day, or 100 gram chicken in a day, or 1 piece of fish in a day, it will not affect your uric acid at all.
Yeah. One more question is a motherly question. It is, we know that milk is a overall nutritional diet, it is food, but children, they refuse it to have that milk. So any other solutions like to provide? One more is egg is there, but some vegetarians, they prefer a milk. In such conditions, how a mother can manage?
Yeah, children refuse to drink milk. As far as possible, try to give plain milk. If it is not possible and the child is refusing totally, try to make it into a fruit milkshake that include a banana milkshake, minus the sugar, of course, but you can add some jaggery to it, which is very healthy. Or you can sweeten it up with, say, dates, a banana date milkshake. So these are things that you can give, or a peanut butter that you can add in the milk as a shake, or a dry fruit milkshake. These are things you can easily give to that. A small amount of sugar will not do anything. No harm. So a half teaspoon of sugar, try to make it a little, tasty, and may give them to them. So milk can be had in different forms. You can, it's not necessary milk has to be drunk only as milk. Make it in the form of a payasam and give. That is also intake of milk only. So don't have this in the brain that milk has to have be given only in a glass. You can give it in the form of an ice cream. You can give it as a form of a milkshake. Give it as a payasam. Give it as a rasgulla. That is also milk. So make sure whatever the child likes, give it to him. But don't make it a habit. Once in a while, introduce milk in this form. As far as possible, try to give a plain glass of milk.
Thank you, ma'am. Expected answer. Motherly question, motherly answer.
Yes.
that I think for a father, these type of things will not run his in mind. That is true. It is
so true. So true.
And madam, even in advertisements, we have seen that having a Complex or having a Horlicks, they say that this much of height will grow. Whether really that is a true one or...
Height is genetic, period. There is no way you can improve your height with any food. So anybody giving you any supplement to improve height, it is fake. They are only making money out of you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Completely genetic and hereditary.
Madam, one question finally I want to ask is that what will be your suggestion on this nutrition concern to women and for the child? Because this session is specially for women teachers. So, your suggestions.
For children, of course, I have spoken a lot. So, I think all the women must have got it. Children are very fussy eaters. It is important that you inculcate the healthy habits initially, right from their childhood. And then only those habits will go into adulthood. Once they learn bad habits, it is very difficult to take them out of, changing eating habits. That is for children. And the maximum growth takes place during their adolescent years and especially in toddler's years. So toddlers and adolescents, be extremely careful what you're feeding them. And also there is a lot of research which says that when you introduce sugar in infant's milk, that is when the sugar craving starts. So start with giving plain milk without sugar or any toddler foods without sugar, and they will not develop a taste for sugary foods. That is the most important thing for growing children. For women, for women, of course, different ages require different types of nutrition. But if you're looking at women above 35, 40, they're almost into a perimenopausal stage and a lot of bone resorption, as we call it, or bone weakening in lay terms, happens not only because of calcium intake, because of hormonal changes as well. So make sure that you exercise regularly. Exercise is the only one that keeps you healthy, and it will keep, and as long as you're moving your body, the hormones will be balanced in your body. Apart from that, a balanced diet that contains a lot of protein, we call it as sarcopenia, which is a old age muscle-related reduction in the body, not only for women and men also, but women, it is very, the symptoms are very, very exaggerated. And women get affected very easily with sarcopenia. So the slouching in the body, the bending, as you see old women bending, all these things are avoided. If your diet is rich in protein as well as, calcium. So these are two, protein and calcium, two important nutrients that I will always stress for women as they grow older.
Madam, one more concept is concerned to this televisions only. They say that a zero figure means a very slim one. Whether that opinion is right or means nowadays the publicity is like that. Whenever they say a fat or a cholesterol, they take it in a negative way only. So can you give a suggestion that whether cholesterol is absolutely a negative one or it has any advantage also?
The first question that I would answer, don't go by zero figure. Don't go by numbers on your scale. First thing is my health profile good? Am I healthy? Whether I am fat or whether I am thin doesn't matter. I am healthy, and that is important because there are a lot of extremely thin people who are extremely unhealthy. Okay, so don't go by numbers. Numbers is not for women or men or anybody in general. Look at health in totality as a whole. The second thing that we are talking about, you've seen a lot of people advertising themselves at zero figure, we'll get your weight down. Lot of influencers, as we call it, undergo lot of procedures. What you see on social media is not real. So don't go by what people show you in advertisements. Make sure you eat healthy and you maintain a healthy diet. That is more than important. Enough. The second thing that we're talking about, fat and cholesterol, please don't avoid fat and totally from your diet. A lot of people have oilless food. Some people are cooking food in water also. That's what I understand. I have a lot of clients who cooked in water, but they develop a lot of connective tissue problems, a lot of joint problems. fat, minimum fat is required for joint lubrication, as we call it. So when we move our joints, that is where the good fat gets accumulated. So take choose vegetable oils. Mustard oil is extremely good. We pay a lot of money and buy olive oil. It has similar properties as a mustard oil. So please don't spend a lot of money on fad oils. Just take some healthy mustard oil is extremely good. Coconut oil is extremely good. If anything in moderation and light amounts are very, very good. Apart from that, please don't get scared of the word cholesterol. Cholesterol is required for the functioning of our cells, for growth of our cells, for our muscles. Everything cholesterol is required. For our hormones, cholesterol is required. So without cholesterol, our body will not function healthily. So that minimum amount of cholesterol, 200 to 250 that we call, is very, very important. That is more than enough. So don't feel your cholesterol is very high. If you go above 500, 600, those are levels that you have to manage, not a 200, 250 level.
Thank you, ma'am. Madam, concern to this age and synovial fluid. Many say that once a synovial fluid is reduced from our joints, that cannot be replaced.
Yes.
Whether is it true or we can have a support of a food also to regain it?
Normally, food doesn't help in this fluid. The only thing that helps is exercise. So exercise, jitna aap karoge, utna uske effects kam rahenge. But otherwise, it is difficult with food. Honest answer.
Madam, again, concern to those televisions only. Nowadays, the advertisements are coming. Within a month, they will reduce 5 kg or 6 kg. Like packages are coming now. So artificially, they are doing it, they are removing the fat from our body. Whether that is a right scientific way to reduce the weight?
What you're seeing is they are making money out of you. Okay, what you will reduce is not fat. What you will reduce is your money. That is all. The bottom line is that. Because in 1 week, you cannot lose fat. What normally people do is they reduce your water content and show you that they have reduced your fat. Within a week, you will reduce 3 kgs. But what is gone is not fat. That is water. Okay. So initially, first 15 days of any diet, you will not reduce fat. You will reduce only water content in your body. And you feel very happy saying that, yes, I have reduced in 15 days, 3 or 4 kgs. Don't fall for that. Any diet or any lifestyle changes has to be sustainable. I cannot live on vegetables and fruits all my life. Right? So anything that needs to be sustainable, the whole, I should be able to continue it for 6 months. You can eat a small light meals in a given day and reduce your weight for 6 months or whatever. See, unless you're participating in a Miss World or Miss Universe competition, what is the race to reduce weight? A 3-4 kgs in a month is a healthy weight loss in a month. Okay. And most important here, you should not forget, lose weight, but you need to preserve muscle in your body. And when you're trying to preserve muscle, it will not show in numbers on your weighing scale. So don't get disheartened that you're not losing weight. Look at your measurements. Don't look at the weight on the scale. That you must always remember.
Thank you, ma'am. Still, so many questions are there, but compulsion we have that we have to conclude also. So finally, I request a suggestions for this session for our participants. In 2 lines, can we finish this one?
Yes. It was a very interactive session. Normally, there are a lot of questions in nutrition. I wish I could answer everybody's questions. So maybe we could have a session again anytime if possible, whenever I will squeeze in some time, and we can have more only question and answer session rather than a presentation session.
Thank you, ma'am. Very inspiring, very motivating, and many more confusions were clear today. Any more answers? We got an exact answer from an expert. Thank you very much. I hope even our participants will carry this information. They will implement those things in their life also. with us. I thank on behalf of Ministry of Women and Child Development, Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports, Fit India, Khelo India, Sai LNCP, and behalf of our respected principal, sir, I thank you for valuable presence and valuable presentation on this occasion. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, thank you, principal, sir, for this opportunity. Thank you very much.
Thank you.